हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द माय यूट्यूब चैनल थियोरेटिकल एग्री स्टडी। सो टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट द वेरियस टर्म एसोसिएटेड विथ एग्रीकल्चर क्रॉप्स। सो इन टुडे लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द टर्म इज क्योरिंग, डीसकरिंग एंड रैबिंग इन टोबैको, रेटिंग एंड स्ट्रिपिंग इन जूट, निपिंग इन ग्राम, रैपिंग, टाइंग एंड प्रॉपिंग इन शुगर कैन, डीटेसलिंग इन मेज, जीनिंग एंड टॉपिंग इन कॉटन, स्टैकिंग इन टोमेटो, टिपिंग इन टी, परबॉइलिंग इन राइस, अर्थिंग अप इन पोटैटो एंड शुगर कैन, स्टेडिंग इन सनफ्लावर एंड लॉपिंग इन ल्यूसन। सो फर्स्ट वी डिस्कस अबाउट द क्योरिंग एंड रैबिंग। So curing is a process by which the harvested tobacco leaf is made ready for the market. It is a well standardized process, especially in FCV, means flue cured Virginia tobacco. To achieve the desirable qualities in the cured leaf along with the removal of moisture, also same practices of removing moisture is done in the tea. Then other term is rabbing. Rabbing means it is a process of burning of thrashes, weeds or any organic refuse on the soil surface. For rabbing, 15 to 20 centimeter thick layer of leaves, weeds or paddy straw is uniformly spread over the surface and then in burnt. So in the photograph, first we see the cured tobacco leaves. In second photograph, it is a photograph of tea, and in the third, rubbing processing done by the burning of the leaves or weed or paddy straw. Then topping and desuckering in tobacco. So topping is, it is a removal of the terminal bud just after the appearance of the flower bud, and in desuckering, removal of the suckers, especially fourth shoots, is known as desuckering. Both the procedure ensure that as much of the plant's energy as possible focus on the producing the large leaves that are harvested and sold. So it is a economically beneficial for the farmer to produce the large number of leaves by the due exercise is topping and desuckering. In the photograph, we simply say that the farmer is topping the leaves, flower buds. Then after the another term is ratting and stripping in jute. So first of all, what is a ratting? It is a process in which the tied bundle of jute stalks are taken to the tank by which fiber get loosened and separated from the woody stalks. The bundle are stripped in water at least 60 cm to 100 cm depth. The ratting process is completed in 8 to 30 days. When the bark separate out easily from the stick or wood and the fiber are ready for the extraction. And in the stripping, it is the process of removing the fibers from the stalk after the completion of the ratting. So in the first photograph, we see the bundles of jute are stripped in the water. In second photograph, the farmer is doing the process of ratting, and in third, farmer is doing the process of stripping. Then after the term nipping, it is associated with gram. Nipping, it is a special cultivation practices of plucking the apical bud of the crop at about the 30 to 40 days after the sowing. Nipping offshoots the apical growth and promote the lateral branches. Thus the plant become more vigorous and produce more flower and pods, and yield per plant is increased. So in photograph, we see the farmers are doing the nipping. If you not watch our old video, so click on the I button, you see the playlist of our various videos. Then after the रैपिंग टाइंग एंड प्रॉपिंग प्रोसेस इन शुगर कैन. सो टाइंग रैपिंग एंड प्रॉपिंग आर डन इन शुगर कैन जस्ट टू प्रोवाइड द मैकेनिकल सपोर्ट टू द ग्रोथ अप कैन प्लांट टू प्रिवेंट लॉजिंग. सो इट इज मेनली डन फॉर द प्रिवेंट ऑफ लॉजिंग. By wrapping, the distribution of CO2 become easy and proper to all of the plants throughout the field. The dried leaves are removed from the plants and the green leaves on the plant are wrapped together and all the cams of one bundle. After wrapping, the clumps in adjusted row are tied together. When wrapping and tying is over in the entire field, the field clump are given further support of bamboo poles from the outside, one or two opposite side of the field. So in the first photograph, we see the support to the sugarcane plant. In the second photograph, we see the green leaves are wrapped together in the sugarcane. Then after the detasseling in maize. So what is the detasseling? Detasseling, it is the removal of the tassel from the female parent. So detasseling is done when the tassel emerge out to the of the boot leaf, but before the antheses have sent pollen. In the maize, generally proto-antheres condition is present, so it promotes the cross-pollination in the maize. Anther takes 2 to 4 days to dehiscence after the complete emergence. Only in few cases the anther start dehiscence before it complete emergence. In such case, detasseling should be done earlier. Detasseling is done every day from the emergence of tassel up to 14 days. So in the photograph we see the process of detasseling. Then after the ginning and topping in cotton. So ginning, it is a process of separating the cotton fiber from the cotton seeds. It is called as a ginning. Perfect ginning operation would be performed if the separation of fiber from seed was effected without the slightest injury to either seed or the fiber. So without the injury to seed or fiber, it is called as a perfect ginning operation. In photograph, we see the ginning machine where the cotton fiber is separated from the cotton seed. Topping, it is an agricultural technique in which the shoot tips of cotton plants are cut off by farmers. It has been used to increase the crop yield. Cotton topping has been reported to reduce bollworm infestation without negatively affecting cotton yield. It is the very important multiple choice questions for the any exam preparation. So in the photograph we see the farmer is doing topping exercise. Then after the stacking, it is mainly used in tomato plants. So stacking, it is a technique used in tomato to give the support to the plants to grow. In this tie, the stem of your tomato plant to the support structure every 6 to 8 inches as they grow. The growing stem are soft and easily damaged, so you need to tie them loosely. So in the stacking, in the photograph we show they with the help of any supportive system the tomato is grown. Then after the tipping, the term tipping is associated with the tea crop. When the shoots grow in tea, but after the pruning or skipping, they are tipped and dissipated at a predetermined height parallel to the ground surface. This operation is called as a tipping. Essentially, the initial fruit out of plucking are also called as a tipping. In the photograph, we see the farmer who doing the tipping exercise with the machines. Then after the parboiling term is associated with the paddy crop. So parboiling is involved the partial boiling of the paddy before milling in order to increase its nutritional value, to change the texture of cooked rice and to reduce the breakage in milling. So here is the most important part. Parboiling is conserve the vitamin B1 thiamine. Parboiling is done in 3 steps. soaking, steaming and drying. So here we see the clear difference between parboiled rice and the white rice. Parboiled rice is slightly yellowish and white rice is completely white. And here is the process of the parboiling. Thank you everyone. If any suggestion, please do comment. And so thank you friends. Do like, share, subscribe, comment to our YouTube channel. Thank you.